It was all a dream on the scene, making mean.
Then I came along and changed everything.
From ciphers to diapers.
Green jiggly things.
But the grind don't stop.
We just got a bigger team.
All the way to the top.
Mom, what does that mean?
The time is now or never. We are dream team.
I was gonna get paid for this.
What's up, guys? It's your girl, Larry Kane, aka Nene, aka whatever it is that you want to call me. She's in the shower right now, on the bath. But yeah, back with yet another reaction video. Hope you guys didn't miss me too much. I totally missed you guys. Hope you guys all enjoyed your holiday. For those who celebrated 4th of July, get in the comment section down below and let me know what you did. We turned up over here. We had a block party. Definitely was cool in a new community. Got to meet a lot of the neighbors and a bunch of the badass kids. Oh yeah, definitely had fun. As you can tell by the video title, today I will be reacting to Machine Gun Kelly Merry-Go-Round. This is actually the lyric video. The official video will be in the description box down below, as well as all of my social media links. Make sure that you follow us on IG, Best Friends Since Birth. Also check out my music page on IG, Lyric Kane Official. Also in the description box down below, you'll be able to find my other YouTube channel. Please head over there and check out my music. If you like what you hear, then go ahead and give the video a thumbs up, subscribe, and turn on notifications so that you don't miss out on all of my latest music videos, original songs, cover songs, remakes, remixes, challenges, and live performances. And I broke my headphones within these last 2 days, so I am stuck using my daughter's, but I'm super grateful because she let me, and it was actually her idea. At least I know I'm raising her somewhat right. Not yet, baby cakes. Hold on, let me finish this video. All right, let's go ahead and let's see. That's right.
Look, summer day. Bobby and his girl would wake up every summer day. This boy and girl had nothing, they were runaways. So in love that now all they wanted was pain. And so it came. Never had a silver spoon present in the past. Now at last the spoon's present. And so the boy wed it. Told her bring him a slab of cotton swab in the match. And told her one day to fly across the world and have a wedding. Like, baby, I have a plan. Come with me to this place. Baby, give me your hand. Now flip it, give me your vein. Baby, take off your belt. We'll use it as a restraint. She sees that it starts to melt. He reaches inside a case. Fills the needle with food. Flicks the needle with haste. Brings the needle to her. She is the right in the face. The boy can tell that she's scared. He says, I love you, okay? Then shoves it into her arm and says, how the fuck does that taste, baby, baby, baby? Dress drops, her head drops, swigging out of a whiskey bottle. He just watched, but he was not Bobby. See, Bobby had joined the army, been gone for a couple months. Now she messing with everybody, every one of the dealers. Everyone here's a squealing, trading pussy for product. She did anything for that feeling, but then she started that feeling. Early morning, she's kneeling in front of the toilet. Look at her belly, there's no concealing that she's expecting a child. This woman is living foul. She's only 20 years old and hardly can't even smile. Ultrasound shows a baby that's barely over a pound. Sold everything in a house, just trying to score an ounce. News of a baby's father was that he died in the war. Now that syringe is all that keeps her alive anymore. No mattress, so her and the child dying on the floor. It's the letters at the door reading, I'll be home tomorrow. Love, Bobby. Bobby. Knocking at the door but doesn't get an answer. Bobby's nervous, his heart starts to beat faster. He hasn't talked to his girl in so long. She sold his phone but we're hit. Damn, how he wished that he could hear her laughter. But his drug hit her like a cancer. And he forgot cause he had left and cleaned his act up. Passenger seat in his Acura got a picture of him kissing under the words happily ever after. He walks into the house, it's a fucking disaster. Every step he takes, his shoe crushes a capsule. Holds his breath, he knows what he smells is unnatural.
looks down as the body of the queen of his castle.
Baby, please, wake up.
He screams on his knees and he sees a hand around the stomach inside for the child and realizes it was his. Summer day, an entire family died on that summer day. Cause a facade made a girl give her love away. But those were Bobby's consequences that he had to pay. Love is pain.
There was definitely dope and definitely deep. Love the storytelling aspect out of it, of course. Was bruh giving me Eminem vibes though? Totally reminded me when he started saying baby please wake up. His pitch and his voice totally start giving me Eminem Kim. If y'all ever heard that track where he like kills his wife or ex-wife, whatever you want to call it. Crazy track, but crazy like artistic wise and creative. But yes, definitely love this. Very, very sad story, but love the way he depicted it. He brought it out. And it's so crazy because with this type of situation, I think it's weird or almost, I don't know, because me personally, I'm drug free and I am alcohol free. But I do know some people never who experimented with at that level. But from books I've read, TV shows I've seen, movies, and kind of like a third person perspective, it's crazy how drugs can have different effects on certain people. How when you usually, yes ma'am, yes ma'am, hold on. Usually when these individuals who introduce people to new drugs, rather it's weed, coke, heroin, whatever it is, they do it with the hopes and the aspects of bringing these people like pleasure or taking them on a trip to like help them cope with something. And it's crazy because usually the person who's offering it or turning the other person out is in a cool state with it. Like they're able to take it and still compose themselves and just like continue, smalls, to continue their day. Can I finish, please? Thank you. And continue their day-to-day progress or whatever it is that they're doing without having any type of issue. And then the person they wind up introducing it has a totally different effect. Like, it's crazy. You can never tell the way these drugs are gonna, like, affect different people or the type of, I don't know how to put it, like, the type of need or desire that they'll have afterward. Like I said, usually the person who gives it, they usually offer it hoping like, oh, this is going to help you get through this one time. And this person, in the books and the movies and the things that I've seen, the person is usually able to cope on the drug. So in my head, that's why they think this other person can. And this other person develops like this addiction or this need or this strong desire, and it just usually just fucks them up. And it's crazy because, I mean, obviously offering drug is never a good thing, but sometimes I feel like in the movies, in the books, it's done in a good intention, you know what I mean? It's offered in a way that's meant to be like, oh, well, this is just to help you get up, but it winds up totally backfiring, which is just really, really crazy. One reason why I'm drug-free, because I think I would be one of those people, like, I would probably take a hit of something and just be somewhere out, crack the fuck out. They'd be like, nigga, you smoked weed. You didn't even take crack. I'm a crackhead, nigga. I'm a crackhead. Like, I'm just weak like that. Like, I don't think I would have the ability to do that. And I've actually drank before, and I swear I'm a lightweight. I barely sip something, and I swear my knees get the buckle in my tongue and my stuff gets numb and I'm just sitting back there rocking like a fucking wino. And I'm like, this bitch only had a sip. That's all it takes for me. A light work. Yeah, but definitely get in the comment section down below and let me know what you thought. Of course, I love the delivery, love the flow. MGK Machine Gun Kelly is bringing it in for the winning. Give me more by this kid. I think I can officially say I'm a fan. I love the way he depicts things. Was Mary supposed to be the chick? That's what I kind of got from it. Mary, go around. Don't want to see you frown. Whatever the hell, whatever's to say. I feel like he was talking to the chick. Crazy. Sad story though, but crazy creative. Go ahead and give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, and turn on notifications so that you don't miss out. And until next time, guys, peace out. I'm out of here.